Welcome back to D-Living. You know, enticing scents can ease your soul, and Lotus Bath Soap is a great way to wash away the stress of the day. Cassie Zobel of Lotus Soap is here to give us a quick lesson in Soap 101. So you hand make every single one of your gorgeous soaps.
Yep, make it all by hand. The soaps, we do lotions, lip balms, creams, sugar scrub.
You make all
kinds
of that?
Yep. All kinds of skin loving goodness by hand.
By hand. Okay, yep. So you're going to show us exactly what you do. I see some tools here.
Yes, yes. You can make soap in your kitchen. But this is not something you want to try at home.
You're putting rubber gloves on.
I am. All soap contains lye, which is actually a caustic chemical. So you want to be really careful when you're working with it. And again,
which one is lye?
This is lye.
Okay.
So we've done a lot of measuring before we got here. And we use coconut milk instead of water. So the coconut milk is frozen, and then we add the lye, and the lye starts to heat it up.
And why do you use coconut milk instead of water?
Because it just makes the soap more creamy and more moisturizing. It just gives it more skin loving goodness. So we mix the frozen coconut milk with the lye and kind of get this slurry here.
Okay.
And then I've already pre-measured all of the oils we need in here. There's four plant oils in here. And then we're gonna add this gorgeous orange oil, which we get by infusing olive oil with paprika.
Now, is that color gonna show in the finished product?
It will look like this.
Oh,
this is what we're making today, Energy Loofah Soap. So this is just infused with kitchen paprika, you know, that you may have put on your deviled eggs last weekend.
Sure.
So we're gonna add that here.
Great. And do you have this over a heat normally when you're doing it?
Well, you want to melt the oils first because I use coconut and organic sustainably sourced palm, which are both solid at room temperature.
Okay.
So you want to melt it, get everything about the same temperature, your lye and your oils.
This is a real art.
It is art and it is science.
Yes.
And it's crazy fun. Okay, so then we're gonna.
You're making
do you
me nervous
stand
with
back?
The lie now.
Yeah, just stand back.
Okay, I'm gonna stand back. I was warned before we went live on the air. Stand back with the lie.
So I'm gonna give this a quick mix just to make sure we don't have any lumps in it.
Okay. Because the lumps would stay lumpy in the soap.
Yep, they'll stay lumpy in the soap, and that's not what you want.
So you're just adding this to the oils.
Adding it straight to the oils. They're about the same temperature. And then this is kind of noisy, but we're going to give it a mix.
Okay.
And you can see it's turning orange.
Can you tilt it forward a little?
Oh, yeah.
There you go. Yeah, it's getting
the orange
color. Turns orange
in there. Yep.
And it'll... kids around because
if anyone
put their little finger in there or something, it would burn. Is that right?
Yeah, you don't want to do this around kids or pets to make sure we keep everybody safe. And then this is our fragrance oil. This is Energy, which is just a really yummy mixture of citrus and it's very refreshing. It's
and
a good morning
fragrance?
Soap.
Add fragrance to this to the finished product?
Yep. Okay. That's how you get
this into it. I'm standing back.
Yep. Just going to throw the scent in there.
Fantastic.
Give it a good swirl, and now we're going to pour it.
Okay.
I just pour it into this mold. This mold makes about 5.5 pounds of soap.
Now, did you make that mold, or is that something that people can get?
No, I bought this.
You bought the mold.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then
can I add loofah, or is that
here,
a dangerous
job? Let me give you some glasses. Gloves.
Okay, I'll let you do it then.
Okay. All right. So we're just
take up all the time putting the gloves on.
Okay. So we're just gonna add the loofah, and we get 10 bars out of this batch of soap.
Okay.
Just set them down in there, and this. What's really cool about this is science is great, and we're taking the lye and the oils, and it immediately is starting to harden and
that
becoming
fast.
Soap. Yeah.
Wow.
So we soap geeks call this saponification, and that process is already starting.
And so how long will it take to completely harden like this block here?
Less than 24 hours.
Okay.
After 24 hours, if you've got a properly formulated recipe, all the lye is out and you're just left with soap and glycerin.
Oh, great.
So in 24 hours, we take it out of the mold and then we cut it. And that's something you can help me do if you want.
Oh, good. Yeah, I'd love to.
So this is what it looks like when it comes out of the mold.
Right. Which is beautiful, by the way.
Yes, and
but
smells
obviously
yummy.
Not practical because it's so big.
It's a big bar of soap. So then you're just gonna take it and cut in between those little loofahs.
Oh, great.
Cut a straight bar.
See how I can do here. It's easier than I thought.
Mm-hmm.
Great. Oh my gosh, great. I cut my first piece of soap.
Woohoo. And then what happens now is it has to cure for about 3 to 6 weeks, and that gives you a nice hard bar. It lets the fragrance do what it's gonna do over the cure period.
That's a long time. So you leave all of these in where? Your factory?
Big racks, yep. We've got big curing
big racks
that we just set them on.
I cut another one. Oh, it's kind of crooked. Can you see?
You're not the first person to ever cut a crooked bar of soap.
It's actually extremely crooked. I'll let you do the rest of that. If you'd like more details, you can check out her website at lotussoap.com. Thanks so much.
Thanks for having me.